diamond balls.
Hey, it's Louise Schofield and I'm backstage at In It Together Festival and I've grabbed Jake Buck. How are you? You good?
I'm very well, thanks Louise. How are you?
Good. Not too bad, not too bad. How was that for you though? The crowd was loving it. I heard the voices singing back to you as well.
It was absolutely fantastic and to be honest, yeah, I'm kind of envious of all the other bands that get to play with the festival because they're in for a real treat with that crowd. So it's an absolute pleasure to play.
Do you always get like quite a warm welcome from Wales? Do you find that it's quite a place where you do get like a nice vibe?
Every time we've played here, they've been a great audience, You know, in various places as well. And yeah, and, you know, they're clearly well into the music and know how to have a good time as well.
Yes.
So it works for us. So.
Exactly. I mean, it's quite a sweaty day though, I have to say. It was a sweaty set, right?
Yeah, it absolutely was. And we got a little bit delayed, which is kind of worked out quite well.
Yeah,
we got a bit of shade by the time we went on.
That's what you were like, just get your shoulders out now, it's going to be okay, literally. But I mean, you've played all over the world. So I mean, do you know, like, can you like cite probably the hottest show you've ever played?
I think one of the hottest shows I ever played, I think it was in Japan, Summer Sonic.
Oh, yeah.
It's so humid there.
Yeah.
And I remember I was playing Broken, which is, you know, quite a sad song.
Yeah, intimate song.
I was sweating so much that it got a little bit got into my eye.
Oh, no.
And the crowd started to think that I was crying while I was playing the song. And,
and
they all started clapping. I was just like,
Love that.
Just stinging.
It's like, thanks, guys. Yeah, cheers. The Japan crowd as well. I mean, like, did you get a lot of gifts when you went over to Japan? Because they're quite, like, with, like, musicians and things, they love it, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely. I think one of my favourite gifts I ever got there was like, you know, it's kind of like I don't know what the actual name is, but it's like a kind of judo suit, but it's like for lounge wear.
Nice.
So it's quite of a strong look when you get your Deliveroo from downstairs in it, but it's like, I quite
There's
like
big
it.
Back, like, give it to me. You've got to keep it forever though, aren't you?
Absolutely.
So it's good. But like you were saying with Broken, I mean, like, it's great. I mean, that album obviously turned 10. I think we spoke at this in an interview last year, like, turned 10, which is makes me feel old because I remember when that album came out and the buzz around Nottingham in general was just incredible. I mean, it's crazy how 10 years has gone so fast.
I know, it blows my mind, to be honest. It's like, especially, and what blows my mind even more is, you know, when I'm singing those songs on stage, that the crowd know them as well, and 10 years on, they're singing along.
Oh yeah.
And it's such a great feeling. And like, I've had a couple of people come up to me and, you know, be like, oh, I was listening to your music when I was growing up. I'm like, oh god.
Does that.
now I'm stuck.
Yeah. Thank you so much for that. But you kind of brought out like an anniversary version as well, and there was a lot of tracks that you didn't release before. So like, were there quite a few tracks on the album that you'd written but just didn't make the cut?
Yeah, absolutely. There was quite a lot of songs. I think when you're writing that first record, you're just writing. And to be honest, I just kind of assumed if they didn't make the record, maybe they weren't good enough. But I hadn't heard them for 10 years. And my managers were like, you should listen to some of these. And so I did. I was like, actually, they're not bad at all. And
I
think maybe the fans will like them.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
So we put it out. And yeah, it's just some extra music for people to enjoy.
Exactly. And that's what they want. You know what I mean? But like, it's true. Like the video you did for that, like you used all footage from kind of like when you were filming that album.
Yeah,
which was so
exactly.
Cool.
And I don't forget you were in one of the videos.
I was
one
as well. Of these back in
yeah,
day,
look
that
the way
me.
You do. That was you.
Hey,
yeah.
Back in the house. Woohoo! That's my place to be, I'll tell you that now. But is it weird to look back on that footage sometimes and be like, oh wow, like I can't believe, like, you know, being in that time? Does it take you back in a nostalgic way?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, it's like, I think also, like, when you see how kind of like moody I was all the time, I'm like, oh, it's that guy.
Yeah,
is it,
yeah.
You know? But you know, it's a different time, and you're in the thick of it. I think, you know, as you get older, you become a little more appreciative of, you know, the opportunities that you've had. And so for me, it's you know, it's great to look back on, but. Yeah, it's been an interesting journey, that's for sure.
That's it. But it's nice. I mean, I saw you at Royal Albert Hall as well, and like, All I Need, I think that was the first time I'd seen you play it live with a choir, which was incredible. I mean, like, having that on the stage, I mean, because when you started, you know, writing the songs in your bedroom like 10 years ago, coming on the stage, now you've got a massive choir behind you for such a huge song. I mean, it's incredible.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's, like, to hear those songs with, you know, that kind of, you know, that extra bit added to it just kind of lifts the whole thing. And it's like, it's kind of, yes, this really amazing feeling that you get on stage when you hear those voices all behind you projecting. And yeah, and especially in a venue like that as well, it's just incredible.
It is. But I mean, Saturday Night, Sunday Morning, because it did have that poppy kind of twist to the album, which was great. But you worked with Steve Mack, who's worked with like some incredibly, like Ed Sheeran, Little Mix.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's great because obviously you work with like Rick Rubin and stuff.
Yeah.
So each album has its own pocket. You know kind of where you want it to go, I suppose.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think, you know, I think it was a bit poppier on the last record. I think I'd like to try and capture on the next album that I'm working on, I think kind of a balance of something between the first and the last.
Ooh,
like, you know,
that's good. That's
kind
a
of
tease.
Songs not, you know, not too traditional in the song sense, but, you know, kind of just stripped back a little bit and
that's
maybe
nice.
Maybe not as production led in a way. But yeah, I love working with Stephen. As I say, I like to try and do something different each record, and it's all a new experience. So I'm interested to see what this one will bring.
That's it, new experience. Well, hopefully no more sweat goes in your eye and you won't be crying. So people on the new album, watch it, because if he's crying, he might be crying in real life. We don't know.
Yeah, I'll try and not make the songs too sad this time.
No, it doesn't happen. Well, Jake, thank you so much for chatting to me. It's always lovely to chat to you. And enjoy the rest of your year, or something's going to be good.
Yes, thank you very much. You too.
Cheers, thank you.
Morning, it's another pure grey morning. Don't know what the day is holding. And I get up right, and I walk right into the path of a lightning bolt.